So, how to change the coefficients how to change the coefficients. Yeah, let's do this now once again. So how to change the coefficients that e of n square is minimized. And that's just easy, and this is done with the help of the so-called gradient descent. So that's our solution. The gradient descent can be understood quite easily. So imagine we have the error signal, the squared error signal. And here we have one of these coefficients h, doesn't matter which one. And so that's our minimum here. Minimum. So best h value is here. And so now, but now imagine we are here. And we have an h value here, and we would like to change our h a bit, and probing basically if the error goes up or down. So what we can do is we can either here at this point go a bit up, or we can go down a bit. So this means here if we are going up, this means here. Error goes up, but that's a bad thing, and so therefore, so I should write h up. This means error goes up, and this means h down again, because that was a bad choice. Yeah. So here, that's the opposite here. If you're moving the h a bit down, so making it smaller, then the error signal also goes smaller. So that's a good thing, and so therefore in this way we should actually increase h, the value, because then it's probably more beneficial. And so we can do the same experiment on the other side. But you see, basically, the idea is that you would like to always go down this valley there, and just to have a somewhat like an intuition of that we can now formalize the gradient descent. So formalize the gradient descent, and so what we are doing is we have a coefficient h of m, and plus one. Oh, let's do this once again. So let's just formalize. Formalize the gradient descent after this intuitive introduction there. So we have a coefficient h of m at the next time step, and So we're changing this slightly at by using value from the current time step and adding a small weight change h of m n. And so this is our small coefficient change. And so the small coefficient change, remember, it's always the opposite when we wiggle on the value a bit. So this means that, so if we are taking the derivative of the error, and wiggle a bit on the derivative, then the h should be always the opposite, that we are rolling down this slope here. So that's the intuitive idea there. Remember, so that's the h of m, and we have something like this here, that we're always going towards this value there. Oops, that's not completely visible. Let's just move it a bit up. H of m, and so this is our so-called gradient descent here. This formula here. And so now the issue with this formula is E is somehow like dependent on the coefficient h of m, and so then now we need to basically have a look what h of m is. So let's solve this equation there. So delta h of m, if we just substituting the error there, then we have here the partial derivative of d of n minus y of n. So that's our definition of, that's the way we're calculating the error signal. And so now, still the partial derivative, we cannot calculate this here, but we know that the y of n, that there the h's are in there. Yeah. So remember, that y of n is the definition of our FIR filter in the time domain. And so we have, so the that's the coefficient here at the moment in time n, and then this is taken from the previous signal here, and remember that's a different notation here, just to make clear, you know, that we have a that's the coefficient number m at a moment, it's not readable here, at moment n. So we can substitute this now into the formula here, and so that we have the, let's just go a bit further out here, because this might be getting a bit longer. Delta hm, and so we can substitute this here minus mu half, and then here we have our partial derivative here, d of n, and then minus, so the sum. Multiplied by x n minus m, like that, and then the partial derivative is down here, h of m. And so now here we have now finally we can take the derivative here. So there's the h of m here in the sum. And yeah, sorry, you see this is missing. There's the square here. And so if you're taking now the derivative here, obviously, this is here, we have to be careful with the chain rule. So the chain rule says, so first we have got the square here, which moves to the front. So the square cancels out the half here. Yeah, so and then the hm, because of the chain rule, brings out the minus x n minus m in front of it. Yeah, so we're getting the x minus n and also the negative sign here, so the negative sign is cancelled out. And so we need to be careful with the chain rule here. Oops. And okay, so then this gives us, if we apply the chain rule to this delta HM, and then this is here mu, and then we've got here the half multiplied by 2, so this goes away, and then also the negative sign goes away, and then we have d of n minus y of n to absorb this wieder this again into that, and then x of n minus m. Remember this here came from the chain rule, and so then we have mu, and then d of n minus y of n multiplied by x of n minus m, and so now we know that this here is our error signal. Let's move it a bit further down, and so. And this is here e of n multiplied by x of n minus m. Yeah, so that's our delta h m. And this is now our, which is a so-called learning rule. So what we see here, so it's very simple to change the weight. Yeah, so this is here the weight change, or the change of the coefficient change. Coefficient change. This is here, dass die. This is a so-called learning rate. So we know this already here. This is our error signal. What's the half here? And then this here is just the value at the value of the delay line. So all pretty easy to understand. And so the error signal, if we are going back to our circuit diagram here, so let's just redraw this here. H of m equals to mu, so learning rate multiplied by e of n multiplied by x n minus m. So that's our learning rule. So this means if we are thinking of our FIR filter, how this works here. that so if we think of this here, that's the H zero, and then here we have the H one, and then we summing this up here. So that's our y of n, and that's our x of n. So this means here, then at this point here, that's x of n, and then here at this point here is x of n minus 1, and so on. And so we see already that's just pretty easy now to apply this rule here. And so what we do is, so we take this signal here, and multiplying this with the error signal, and then just changing the weight here. Yeah. So this is then our e of n here, and we do the same again here. So that the output is there, and this is here also again e of n, and so on and so on. And so therefore we see that that's the actual concept of this here. Yeah, so this is here our delta H0, and this is here our delta H1. Yeah, that this directly translates into a very simple coding rule how to implement this basically in our FIR filter. So we just need to write a simple update rule, which is multiplying the h of n or h of n minus 1, or just always with the error, and changing the weight of that. And so that's all basically what needs to be done there. Just went slightly out of frame here. Let's just move it up a bit so that it's all visible here.